Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's humbly be on our feet this evening. God bless you for coming to church. Tonight we are here to give praise, worship, and honor to our Maker. The Bible says that let all that have breath praise the Lord. The psalmist said that as long as he has breath, is going to praise his Maker. So within this few space of time, let's come before God with praises, with worship, with adoration.
Hini kesie hallelujah. Oh yeah, that was you. Yeah, you are, yeah. Oh, hini kesie. nyamin ofata o ofata o ofata yi o ofata o ofata nasi o ye ye eradi Rati Sewu Hallelujah Si Sewu Yesu Christo Hallelujah Entibia Si Amen Ina Kasewu Kutu Hallelujah, oh, oh, in it, yeah, run to Sebu, oh, to Sebu, Yesu Christo, hallelujah, in Tibia, si amen, yina, kase, Unkutu na uyohin.
This few seconds or minutes, I want you to thank God. Just for 2 minutes. Thank God in your own way. God has been so good to us. Lord, we thank you this evening. We thank you for the rain. We thank you for our life. We thank you for your provisions. We thank you that this evening we are still alive, and then Lord, you have a purpose for us. You know why we are here this evening. And Lord, we are mortals before you this evening. We give you glory. We give you honor. We exalt your name. The psalmist says that as long as he has breath, he's going to praise the Lord. So Lord, we agree with the psalmist, and we are here together with one accord. We are here to give you praise. We are here to give you honor. We are here to worship your name. Lord, be exalted. Come and accept our praises and our worship. Let it be sweet smelling savor before you, Lord, this evening. Lord, let us ascend to your throne. Lord, we commit ourselves into your hands tonight, Lord. We pray and ask that our worship will be accepted in your sight tonight, Lord. Purge and cleanse us. Wash us with your blood. Lord, we come with so many faults and mistakes, Lord. But Lord, you take what is broken and Lord, you make it well. Lord, we come before you this evening. We bring our praises and our worship to you this evening. Thank you, Jesus Christ, for your grace. Thank you, Father.
Yes, amen. Nina kase wunkuto na wu yoin.
Sing a few hymns to praise our God. Sing, I'm pressing on the upward way. So we'll clap.
I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Still praying as, oh, I'm onward bound. Oh, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Lord, lift me up and let me stand by faith on heaven, stable land. Oh, a higher plane, higher than I have found. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. My heart has no desire to stay where doubts arise and fears dismay. Though some may dwell worthies abound. My prayer, my oh, is higher ground. Oh, Lord, lift me up and let me stand. Oh, by faith on heaven, stable land. Oh, a higher plane, higher than I have found. Oh, Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. I want to scale the utmost high. Oh, and catch a glimpse of glory bright. But still I pray, oh, till heaven I found. Oh, Lord, lead me on to higher ground. Lord, lift me up and let me stand. Oh, by faith on heaven, stable land. Oh, a higher plane than I have found. Oh, Lord, plant my feet on higher. Father, I long will, oh, know all about. Oh, Father, I long will, oh, understand why. Oh, cheer up my brother, oh, live in the sun. Oh, and we'll understand, oh, all by and by. Oh, tempted and tried, we of me to wonder why it should be thus all the day long. Oh, while there are all others, oh, living above, but as, oh, never more less stand, doing the wrong. Oh, Father, alone will know all about. Father, alone will understand why. Oh, cheer up, my bro, live in the sun. Oh, we'll understand, did all by and by. Oh, and when death has come, then taking our loved ones, oh, it lifts our hopes so lonely and dread. Oh, then do we wonder why others prosper, living so weak, oh, year after year. Hallelujah, Father, know all about. Oh, Father, alone will, oh, understand why. Oh, cheer up, my brother, oh, live in the sunshine. We'll understand it all by and by. time we have no long to stay. Oh, the stormy clouds of darkness will turn to brighter day. Then let us all take courage, for we are not left alone. Oh, the lifeboat soon is coming to gather the jewels home. Oh, then cheer, my brother, cheer. Our trials will soon be over. Oh, our loved ones we shall meet upon the golden shore. We are pilgrims and we are strangers here. We are seeking a city to come. Oh, the lifeboat soon is coming to gather the jewels home. Oh, sometimes the devil tempts me and see it's all in vain to try to live a Christian life and walk in Jesus' name. But then we hear the master say, oh, I'll lend you a helping hand. Oh, and if you'll only trust me, I'll guide you to the land. Oh, then cheer, my brother, cheer. Oh, I try. Hallelujah. Our loved ones we shall meet upon the golden shore. We are pilgrims and we are strangers here. We are seeking city to come. Oh, the lifeboat soon is coming to gather the jewels home. This moment, you are going to sing a few praise songs to our God. When you sing and clap your hands, shake yourself. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ. God has been so good to us. Nyankuponye yiwaye, yebomukase wuni eradi. Suni asasi nyina, kutuwo odu maku daeja. Oh, nyankuponye yiwaye, yebomukase wuni eradi. Suni asasi nyina, kutuwo odu maku daeja. Oh, yebesum wo da da da, yebesum wo da da do. Oh, yebesum wo da da da, yebesum wo da da. Nyanku poye yiwa ye, yebomukase woni eradi. Oh, suni asasini na kutuwo odu maku daeja. Oh, yeah, besum wo. Oh, yeah, besumbo. Oh, yeah, besumbo. Da, 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 yeah, besumbo. That we praise thy name, O Lord. Oh, we praise thy name, O Lord. We praise thy name, O Lord. We praise thy name, O Lord. Hallelujah, we praise. We praise, O Lord. Oh, we praise thy name, O Lord. We praise thy name, O Lord. We praise thy name. Glory be to my Lord. Hallelujah. Be to my Lord. I say glory be to my Lord. Glory be to my Lord. I say glory be to my Lord. Glory be to my Lord. Oh, and your yam coming and coupon. Hallelujah, and your yam coming and coupon. Missy and your yam coming and coupon. Hallelujah, and your yam coming and coupon. I say, glory be to my Lord. Glory be to my Lord. I say, glory be to my Lord. Glory be to my Lord. Oh, Asafu, Asafu, Yehovah, Niye, Ewo, Hallelujah. Asafu, Asafu, Yehovah, Niye, Ewo, oh, Nyankupon, oh, Nyankupon, oh, Niye, Mbwafu, Kesi, Hallelujah, Asafu. Asafu Yehovah niye, Ali 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 Hallelujah, oh ha, oh one more time, Ali Ali Hallelujah, ah, oh me say Hallelujah, oh Hallelujah, praise the Lord, oh Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, praise. Oh, yebemasu, 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 yebemani dinsu, amenina beunse, yesu dinaya masu, hallelujah, yebemani dinsu, hallelujah, oh, yesu dinaya, oh, oh, mehu, oh, yesu. Joseph Banu, oh, Nyatitifu, Kani Wasem, Hallelujah, Mehu, oh, Yesu, oh, Joseph Banu, oh, Nyatitifu, oh, Kani Wasem, oh, Sebri, Bri, Baby. Betu mi free Nazareth aba mumbrabeche Yesu ajinkwa mumbrabe sabibi pebi betu mi free Nazareth aba mumbrabeche Yesu ajinkwa. Glory be to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Oh, I say glory be to God in the highest. Everybody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everybody shout hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, oh man me, unye radia ye no yo hini kokoko. Oh man me, oh unye radia ye. Oh man me, unye radia ye o yo hini kokoko. Oh man me.
Wow. Clap your hands, put your hands together. Oh, wa mama kuma tomiyem. Oh, moja disyo shegu wakavari nunti. Wa mami suma sebine. Oh, moja disi, oh. Oh, wa mama kuma tomiyem. Oh, moja disyo shegu wakavari nunti. Wa mayen suya sebine. Oh, moja disi, momo. Oh, moja disi. Moja disi. Oh, wa mayen suya sebine. Oh, moja disi, momo. Oh, moja disi. Moja disi. Oh, wa mayen suya sebine. Moja disi, momo. Moja disi, moja disi. Oh, wa mayen suya sebine. Moja disi, momo. So it was because of his blood, his death, that we are alive this morning. Sorry, this evening. And it's befitting of us to give the praise and the honor to him. We have our hands, we have our feet. Paul and Silas in the prison didn't have instruments. With their voices, with their hands, just two people were able to sing, and the glory of the Lord came down. So whenever we come to God's presence, let's use it as an opportunity to praise into victory, to worship into victory. Amen. We'll sing this song as we invite God's minister in.
There waits for me a bright tomorrow, where springs of heaven swing open wide. And when I've passed this veil of sorrow, I'll camp upon the other side. Someday beyond the reach of mortal ken, someday God only knows just where and when. The wheels of mortal life shall all stand still, and I shall go to dwell on Zion's hill. Someday beyond the reach of mortal ken, someday God only knows just where and when. The wheels of mortal life shall all stand still, and I shall go to dwell on Zion's hill. Someday beyond the reach of mortal ken, someday God only knows just where and when. The wheels of mortal life shall all stand still, and I shall go to dwell on Zion's hill. Someday beyond the reach of mortal ken, someday God only knows just where and there wheels of mortal life shall all stand still, and I shall go to dwell on Zion.
Shall we pray? Merciful Father in heaven, we bless your name tonight. Jehovah, you are the reason that we've come here this evening. For that we've come to worship, to adore you. Father, we thank you because you've made us the most privileged people on earth. That, Lord, you've chosen us even before the foundation of the world. Therefore, Father, tonight we want to uplift your name. And the Bible says that when we lift up your name, you draw men unto yourself.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for making it possible and the desire in our hearts not to stay home or late at our workplaces, but to come to fellowship tonight. Lord, the Bible says that nobody come before you and leave the same. Father, we have come knowing that we will not leave as we have come. We'll leave here to become better people, better Christians, a better bride of Christ, with all our needs and sublimation met, O God. Father, Lord, humble as I am, I lay myself aside. Just come and take the vessel. May you sanctify, fill with your spirit, and use to bless the children this evening. Bless the pulpit to the pew. May you minister to our soul, O God. May your word refresh us, O Jesus. Amen. Strengthen and fortify us for the rest of the journey ahead of us to prepare ourselves. So if it be that you should come even tomorrow, we shall say, here we are, Lord, we are ready.
Amen.
For our needs are also before you, O God. For I will know you will not leave us, O God, as we have come. But for I will live filled, O Lord, with your word, filled with all our needs met, O Jesus. Father, many on their way coming, Father, we ask that you bring them safely here. We subdue every spirit of doubt and unbelief that will try and intervene in their worship even this evening, O God. We bless you. We thank you for an answered prayer. For in Jesus Christ's name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen.
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 Shall I give the Lord Jesus a clap of praise? God bless you, brothers and sisters, for coming to fellowship this evening. Amen. God bless you all. Amen.
Amen.
So today is a prayer meeting day.
We
want to take some few thoughts and we'll go into prayers. We don't have anything new. It's just to re-echo what the message has said. But it's my desire that God will reveal his words to you and that you put his word into action and put you into faith to pray. Okay, so without wasting much time, we'll read two scriptures. 1 Kings chapter 17, verses 8 to
16.
And we read Matthew chapter 6, verses 31 to 34. I read 1 Kings. And the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, unto Elijah the prophet, arise and get thee to Zarephath, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. So he arose and went to Zarephath. And when he came to the gate of the city, the widow woman was there gathering of sticks. And he called to her and said, fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel that I may drink. And as she was going to fetch it, he called to her and said, bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in thy hand. And as she said, as the Lord thy God liveth, I have not a cake, but a handful of meal in my barrel, and a little oil in my cruse. And behold, I am gathering two sticks that I may go in and dress it for me and my son, that we may eat and die. And Elijah said unto her, fear not, go and do as thou hast said, but make me therefore a little cake first, and bring it unto me, and after make for thee and for thy son. For thus said the Lord God of Israel, the barrel of meal shall not waste, neither shall the cruse of oil fail until the day that the Lord sendeth rain upon the earth. And she went and did according to the saying of Elijah. And she and he and her son and her house did eat many days. And the barrel of meal wasted not. Neither did the cruse of oil fail, according to the word of the Lord which he spoke by Elijah. Matthew chapter 6 verses 31 to 34. Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall I eat? Or what shall we drink? Or wherewith shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have need of all these things. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Take therefore no thought for the morrow, for the morrow shall take thought of it for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. May the Lord add his reading to his word. Amen. Shall
we
please be seated? God bless you once more again.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
It is good to say amen.
When you say amen,
I don't need your amen to encourage me to preach. Because if God had not purposed that I should be here, I won't be here.
And
our pastor is really doing very well. Shall we give a clap of
praise
to Jesus? It is not easy to stand before people who God has purchased with his own blood. This is not like you being a CEO of a company where you've gone to learn a lot of things and you have your PhD.
And
you can use the wisdom of man to manage man.
But
this is a spiritual affair. It's God who does his own things in a spiritual affair. So when you say amen, knowing that the people of Laodicea in these last days, we are the amen. Amen puts your faith uplifted. Amen is an evidence to show you have faith on the word that is coming forth.
Amen.
Whether it will be or it will not be, yours is the promise of God to you is amen. And when you say amen, it also puts the devil to shake. It's very true. When you say amen, you put the devil to a shake. That is why sometimes a child of God in the church, a preacher man will preach, that child by stimulation of revelation,
will
scream amen.
Amen.
Then the unbeliever beside him, or the make believer beside him, will like, what is wrong with this brother? What is wrong with this sister? Why is he acting like a holy roller? Why is he acting like he's crazy? But that child of God is crazy for God. That child of God knows what God has done for him or her. It is just like Abraham said, the eagle and the vulture or the crow. The word goes forth. The eagle says amen. And rejoice in it. The same word. The crow hears it. He rebukes it. Becomes sometimes angry. But it's the same word. There is power in saying amen. And when we also say
amen,
I believe we'll be impacting some godliness in our children sitting around us. Because they may not understand all that the preacher man is saying. But when they see their parents or the elderly brother and sisters, amen, amen. It causes them to be alert of what is going on.
So
sometimes it brings their attention to the service. Do you even know that sometimes even the preaching might be going on, a little child might be saying amen, amen, and the mother or the father will be like, keep quiet. Like they are making noise. Oh, it happens.
It me see.
And I know some of us know it happens.
It me see ewo yentem.
It's like as if we should preach on the word amen.
Amen.
But that's not what we want to share.
Amen.
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 I'll be a little bit fast. Because I don't think we can cover what we I want to share this evening. But I just hope that we'll try to dovetail it. No, I hope that you will try to dovetail
it.
The little thought I want us to share this evening is, put God first and apply the token in prayer. Put God first and apply the token in prayer. Putting God first is a topic on its own. Applying the token is a subject on its own. And being in prayer is a subject on its own. But let's try to get the sermon and dovetail it ourselves for the sake of time. We just read from the scriptures about the woman of about Elijah and the woman of Zarephath.
Zarephath and Elijah.
It is not new to us. And we know what happened over there. Just as we read in the scriptures. It got to a stage in the time of Israel where they thought they had it all. Because God has blessed them even right in their father Abraham's loins. That in blessing, God will surely bless them. To the extent that they occupied a desert land.
tam a esase eye bibie ni so no anana ewo won.
But they were able to prosper.
Now, so emuni na ano wodi ye.
Able to cultivate.
Otumi edua nyoma wosa asase
pese so. Able to harvest.
Otumi etwa.
They have it in abundance.
Onyane dodo.
And they thought it was all their effort.
Now we use when you know
they forgot the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Abraham, Isaac,
to the extent that they elected a king called
Ahab.
After they had rejected God being their king in the days of
Samuel.
And Ahab went to marry an unbeliever.
Now Ahab eko wari anjedieni.
Because he himself, he was an unbeliever.
Ahab
was not a true believer
Ahab,
of Jehovah. He went to marry a
Jezebel.
Who was a daughter of an idol worshipper. But Abraham said he married her because of her beauty.
Abraham says, Ahab wari Jezebel enam na ho ofeso.
And the politics of her father. That is what Abraham said.
And it's no different Abraham car said.
That under no circumstance should a believer marry an unbeliever. Because when you do that, it will put your salvation at risk. Which therefore means that in marriage, in everything we do,
we
ought to put the word of God first. The word of God must come first before beauty or marriage. When he married Jezebel, she introduced idolatry into
Israel
by enticing and deceiving the husband
Ahab.
And Israel as a nation,
now Israel saw mine, no?
Who are supposed to be religious,
I was anchor, yeah, me, some for, no?
After all the signs the prophet of God has exhibited, by the mighty arm of God, they were also deceived. And they went into idolatry. They put God aside and began to worship idols. God, who was supposed to be put first in their life, put aside, and he went to worship idols. But Abraham said, amidst of that, they were still prospering. Because in blessing, God has blessed them. And no enemies could defeat them at that time. Then one day, God, who always looks to his word, who even brings his own word first before he himself. For that reason, he had to die on Calvary. If not, his son Jesus, in the Garden of Gethsemane, would have put away dying on the cross. And if he had done so, you and I would not be here tonight. But because he had to put his word first
about
himself, today you and I, we are partakers of eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
And God remembered his word. But remember, Abraham said, in every age, God has a witness. God has a witness in every age. Right from the Garden of Eden,
every Eden throm,
until the rapture, God has witness in every age. And God witnessed is always not in the multitude. God can have just one man to be a witness of him. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Can we say amen?
Amen.
Abraham said,
what did Abraham say?
In the days of Ahab,
Elijah,
all the prophets,
all
the prophets were deceived.
They
were following Ahab,
and
Jezebel.
Jezebel.
Because of what? Because of money.
Amen.
Because of money. And but Abraham warned us in this message, especially the pulpit, that we should watch popularity. We should watch money. And we should watch women. These three things are very dangerous. And they can bring an anointed man down. Irrespective of the anointing or the gift of God upon you. And I don't believe it goes only for the pulpit. It goes for every brother and every sister. Every one of us.
Amen.
Can we say amen?
Amen.
Time is not by our side. I'm really enjoying the sermon. Can we say amen?
Amen.
But brothers and sisters, we are the most privileged people. But God told Elijah, who was afraid at that time, who was the only witness of God,
he said,
"Fear not, because I have other, is it 7,000 or 700? I don't know that it's 7,000 or 700. I didn't do my research before coming. But take me for what I mean, not what I say. Who have not bowed down
to
Jezebel's idolatry.
Enchre Jezebel abosomsom.
The one that God spoke through the mouth of his prophet Elijah.
Dako yankupo ikasafa Elia odifonim.
He said, because of what you have done, Ahab.
Esan de waye Ahab.
And by my mouth,
enam manosuno,
rain shall not fall down for 3.5 years.
Insuo enton finchia miensa enefa.
Not even dew.
Empobosuo ento.
For 3.5 years,
also,
I shall call for rain again. A man who is flesh and blood, speaking like God. Who is he that is saying I?
Only
a man, Elijah.
Leah.
But Abraham says,
Abraham say,
or even the Bible says,
say,
a man who has no father and no mother. Spoke like God. Until I bring, I speak again. Not even rain or dew shall fall.
Amen.
But they took it lightly.
Nanso,
because they thought they are blessed because they are children of
Abraham.
They had plenty harvest. Just like the rich man who said, oh, my soul rejoice. There is plenty food for today and for tomorrow. And God said, you foolish man, I'll take your soul, your life today. And we shall be what shall become of your harvest. Sometimes we work, we follow so much things of the world. We make a lot of wealth. And very soon we have issues with our health. And we die. And we leave the money. Such a pity that not even for our children, but family members who have no concern about you when you are even sick. So some of you who are working, secure the life of your children. If you shall be no more tomorrow, if God should call you. Those of you working in the corporate environment. If you know you've not updated your pension, your SNITs, Provident Fund beneficiaries, you better go do that.
Insurance, SNITs, na ihonke kano, oyandia, ewose nyo mebi wawose saan.
When I was in my national service, it was my brother, my cousin.
Ebra no oyen national service, no ninya, bema.
But when I got married, it became my wife and my children.
It's
very, very important.
You
can decide to do it now, today.
So
you can decide to go change your beneficiaries today. And even the next day, you can go and change it again. I remember my little girl, I didn't add one of her name to it. I thought it was just a matter of just typing, adding her name. I had to go through the whole process again. This should tell you how serious even SNITs or the pension trustees are serious about issues like this.
Yes, sir. Yeah, we are juma now. If we want to be able to manage juma, see, can't we grab a boy? No, See,
this message has not only called us into things of salvation,
but
by this message we ought to be wise and to prosper on
earth,
so that our children will also benefit. Like the testimony of the brother who was here this on Sunday. What the mother did, putting God first,
and
how that it became a blessing to her children. You may not see it for yourself today, but look at it for your children. The same, we ought to be careful as parents how we are living our life. Maybe as a father, as a mother, as a CEO, as a manager of your company, the way you are living your life. Because if you don't put God first, and you live anyhow, and there's a consequence, it can affect you and your children. Because Ahab thought he was a king. Little did he know that his mistake will affect a nation. His mistake affected a nation. And sometimes, if the mistake of a spiritual leader can accept the church people, but that is what Ahab did. And when it happened, that there was no rain, no drizzling, no dew, and Israel realized that indeed there's a God who had created the heavens and the earth. At that time, probably they could eat 5 times in a day. Abraham said, he said they could eat 5 times in a day. Some could eat 3 times in a day.
You
got to a time, they had to eat only 1 time in a day. You got to a time, they had to eat even 1 time in 3 days. You got to a time, they had to eat once in a week. Because if they don't manage the little that they have, they will die. And this is supposed to take place for 3.5 years. Shall we say amen?
Amen.
But sometimes we don't put God in preeminence. We always look for our selfish interests, not looking at God's interests. Rema, it is putting God first, applying the token, and in prayer. We don't put God first. We don't give him the preeminence. Always looking for our selfish interests. But Abraham said, in every day of our life, we must put God first. In your home, at your workplace, when you are working, Abraham said, when you are working, though you are working for man, see
like
you are working for God. Because as you are working, maybe you are an
agent.
You deal in getting rented apartments or a property for people who wants to buy a property or rent a room. Are you looking for the interest of the person or your own personal interest? You know very well that this apartment has issues. You know very well that in this compound, they have issues with water. They have issues with the roof always leaking. You know that this compound has issues during rainy season. But because of your selfish interest, you want your percentage, your commission on the rent, All the sale on the property. You don't care about that fellow man. You don't put that fellow man first.
I
read a little about Abraham said. That a man must put God first. Must put his family second. And he last.
I'll
read that quote.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Maybe you are a trader. You sell tomatoes. You know very well that this can. Hit the under. So that when you put in the tomatoes or the gari in that long car, it will not be the full measure as it's supposed to be. Whose interest are you putting first?
Now, why are pay your
is it that man's interest by putting God's interest first or your interest? In every aspect of your life, who are you putting first?
Why now did he
let it be? As Abraham said, that if you have the Holy Ghost, you must put God first. You shouldn't even wait. You can't even wait for the church door to be opened. You ought to be the first person in church. You ought to be in church 30 minutes before the service starts. You ought to be the first person. Want you to be in the first few. But today people come.
You
want to take the back seat. You have excuses. Put God first. When it comes to first, church. When you come to church, be the first person to say amen when the preacher man is preaching. Be the first person to lift up your voice to sing when a song leader is leading. Be the first person to clap aloud when the clapping is going on. Be the first person to pay your tithes.
Amen.
Be the first person to pay your offering. Don't you say, my wife is sick. My child's school fees. My rent is due just this end of the month. God, you understand. Oh God, you know. I have
deep
obligations to do. Abraham says, put God first. Your wife is dying.
So you know who?
Your rent is almost due. Your landlord is going to suck you out. Put God first. Pay your tithe first.
Amen.
Shall we say amen?
Amen.
In a message enticing spirit. Paragraph 25. But Abraham said. Give me a preacher. Give me a Christian. Give me a housewife. That's a Christian.
Oh, you're Christian.
Give me a farmer.
Mame okweyeni.
Or a factory worker.
You see?
Or a trader.
Ana obio odiga.
Or a banker.
Ana obio oye jumo jiska
kwa biya. Or a mate conductor.
Ana obio oye mate.
Or a driver.
Ana obio oye driver.
Or a HR officer.
Ana obio oye ni paso.
Or a seamstress.
Ana obio poma diye.
Whatever profession.
Ejume biara woye no.
He said, give me that person. He said, give me a factory worker that will put God first.
Mami sango fe nyina wodi nyangu boy di wedi wenim kan.
In everything.
Ewo adi.
Not some things. Oh God, you know. My wife is dying. My child is sick. I haven't sent my mother her monthly money. He said, put God first in everything.
Show me a housewife.
Show me a preacher man. Show me a
Christian.
Or a factory worker. Who will put God first in everything? And I'll show you a man that will be successful. Shall we say amen?
Amen.
To be successful, you ought to put God first. Oh, hallelujah. Our time is enemy.
It's
not gotten anywhere at all.
Yendu baby biara.
To be successful.
So be you know.
In this message.
I want cransing
in your Christian life.
I want Christo suma brabo
mono. In your social life.
Empo e wa dada sitting
mono. In your marriage life.
I want worry mono.
In your career life.
Empo e wa ojume die
mono. In your economic life.
Empo e wa sike die
mono. In your financial life.
Empo e wa sike same mono.
In your educational life. I want
su komo no.
You got to put God first.
You
need to be successful.
You
need to be a true, genuine Christian. You got to put God first. How can you be a good, genuine, strong Christian? By putting God first. For you to be a spiritual man or a spiritual woman, all you ought to do is to read your Bible and pray. Put God first and apply the token in prayer. We are even just speaking about putting God first. That's what we are even talking about.
Now.
Time is not about our side. We haven't even gotten to about applying the token. We haven't even yet talked about getting into the prayer. God help us. For you to be a spiritual person. Abraham says, pray and read your Bible. This is a question that Abraham gave when a little girl asked him this question. A little girl, how much more you and I, an older person, pray and read the Bible. How many times do you wake up from our bed?
I say, yeah, sorry for your password.
And the very first thing we'll touch
cyber cano
is our mobile phone.
And your crowd to feed you.
I do some.
Means me, yebi.
Somebody will say,
oh, Rebecca, sir.
Oh, I'm looking at the time.
Oh, Meshem Ro.
Oh, somebody will say,
oh, Rebecca, sir.
Oh, it's because the I've set the alarm on the phone. That is why I happen to touch it.
It's our alarm, me. Enyani, and until the mom in sa April, so can I?
Remember,
Kai.
Abraham read this quote.
Do for Abraham making kind sign say me
preach this quote I'm reading.
Or can sign say me
in a message enticing spirit.
In crown somebody can say in whom my dada.
In the spirit of enticement will come.
Oh,
I just took the phone to look at the time.
Oh, na me share mro, me share time abo.
And before I realized.
Na me share no.
And before you realize,
when you
have unread WhatsApp messages.
WhatsApp, go for message, baby.
You have unread Telegram messages.
Oh, call Telegram, say baby.
You have Facebook.
Oh, call Facebook, send
the friend request.
Obia,
awaiting notification.
Obia, what's no so? But some of you madam for.
You have YouTube and Twitter pop up. Notification of new videos that has been uploaded.
Shemi answer.
In the spirit of enticing spirit.
When you na aye endada home.
Oh, let me just check in.
Ah, mami miya ba akuna miche. Mami fantu o meko gari.
You open the WhatsApp.
Ubiye ya.
And you see a message that somebody has sent.
Oshé insembi obi di astuma.
This is coming from my mother.
Hey, where the mommy ho? Mami
she
niye.
I have to respond.
Osa me yina no.
You know she's not feeling what she's saying.
Ah, oyare.
But before I realize,
when you baba honso no,
if maybe you woke up at 5 o'clock.
Well, I'm sorry, and ajumu be donshire and naya.
Before I realize,
when you baba honso no,
5:10.
5:10.
Oh, it's 5:10.
5:10. I'm in trying kakra.
At least if I pray 15 minutes.
Me bom payes ma edunuma
before 5:30.
Me sheno enche.
Before I realize,
we sheno
5:15.
5:15. 5:20. 5:20. 5:10.
And it's 5:30.
Hey, 5:30 abo.
I have to go to work.
Oh, so
I haven't warm water on the fire.
Hey, me report yet.
I haven't ironed.
Me too matter yet.
Oh, I ought to do this.
Hey, what's me
if I don't get to work early, I'll be sacked.
Hey,
because that is why I get my paycheck.
Hey,
that's why I get my daily bread.
Hey,
and we forget to put God first.
Hey, we put
our family first. We put God last. And sometimes
God may not even have a little bit of our time. He doesn't have nothing at all. And the whole 24 hours will be gone. Day and night is gone.
And now,
and the next day will come. And now become the routine of our life. And the message enticing spirits. That is what is overshadowing the people in this end time. Because Jesus told the disciples in Matthew 24.
Yes, you say.
After they asked him what are be the things that will happen in the last days. The first thing Jesus Christ said. He said, watch so that you not be deceived. Because many shall be deceived. He didn't mention anybody's name. He said, if even the elect, if not by the grace of God, they can also be deceived. Do we put God first? Shall we say amen?
Amen.
God help us.
Yame,
we have about like some 5 minutes before we go into praise. In the message, Elijah and a meal offering.
In Kransem, Elia and a
paragraph 25. I may not get time to read everything. But let's see what Abraham is saying here. Abraham in the preaching is like dramatizing it.
About the woman of Zarephath.
There had been 3 years that there had been no rain on earth. That is the widow woman. Abraham said she knelt down on the floor.
Abraham said,
you see how she's going into prayer?
And now what she said, your own ramp, I boom.
Because remember when we're in the scriptures.
Kai say your king can't trust him.
She put God first.
Or the nyangupo edinim kain.
She put the prophet of God, the prophet of God first.
Or the odifo nyami odifo no edinim kain.
She had one last muzzle of meal to eat. The last oil, probably to fry the meal to eat. The last water to drink. But yesterday she gave it to
the
prophet. Because God has read in the Bible. Told Elijah. He said, wake up and go to
Zarephath.
To a widow woman. For I have commanded her. So in God's commanded to the widow woman. She took God fed by taking his commandments. By taking God's commandments, she didn't look at whether she will have anything to eat tomorrow or not.
Because
the Bible says,
trust him, say,
we should take note of what we shall eat or drink or wear tomorrow. It is the Gentiles that do that. It is the unbelievers that do that. It is the make believers in the church that does that. It is the unbelievers in the church that does that. But not the true real believers. Shall we say
amen?
She took God's commandment first. Elijah.
Elia.
You are the same person.
One is our near.
Who spoke and seized the rain from falling. And God took him to the wilderness. To a brook. And God was feeding Elijah through the mouth of crows.
And he
was drinking from the brook.
And
when he got dried, God sent him to the widow. So God commanded the widow woman to do such for the woman. Elijah.
Elijah.
An old man as you are, knowing that this woman is a widow, she has lost her husband. I think we have to continue this message, God willing. Elijah the prophet. You know she's a widow. She's lost her husband. She has a little boy. Probably 2 years old. Maybe she's as little as Baba. Or David, but a friend's son.
Yeah, and maybe sir.
Or your little girl, a 2-3 year old child who can't help himself.
onto me M1 ho.
And an elderly man like you.
Sabema when you Elia when
you
say
telling the woman to give you a water to
drink. Who catch your bay and ocean the
bay. And the woman knew the value of water at that time.
Obanu no nim said the nsue ho din fa.
It was not the shekels that the Elijah wanted, the prophet wanted.
And yes, can I not show?
He just wanted water.
No pensio nano.
At that time, water was valuable.
Water.
She had her last cup of water to drink with her son.
And
then died. But the prophet said, bring me that.
And so Odifo said,
a prophet.
Odifo.
An elderly man like you. What about that little child? Can't you consider that little child? That's how some people might see it today. False prophet in our time.
They'll
try and squeeze money from the people.
Make
merchandise from the people. Especially women. Sometimes they will encourage the women to go out and work.
They
will come them in church on Monday. Tuesday up to Friday. In the name of prayer camp. And most of the time it is women. The spirit of deception. God have mercy. But she was going in to give the last water to the prophet. He said, not only that, but even make a cake for me. But before that, this is what Abraham said. I think I have to summarize because of time.
So that
we're going to prayers. We can't finish. Let me just summarize. In summary, Baba was narrating how she knelt on the floor to pray.
Before Bram, no, or Chenye, Quayan, or Bano.
Lord God Jehovah, thou art the God of our fathers, who has fed the children and cared for them all these many years. Look at how she is praising God in prayer. When we are praying,
you
have to know how to pray. You have to uplift God first. But you ought to be in the atmosphere of prayer. Brother said, he said, I can see her as she cried out to God. It means as Abraham is preaching, God has given him the vision. He said, I can see her as she knelt on the floor and is praying. But some of us, when we are praying, it's like we are falling asleep. It's like we are not serious. Sometimes we are praying. We fold our hands. We are not serious. But if we should be in the hour of desperation, we will be like this woman. He said, I can see her as she cried out to God. She was crying out, calling on God in tears. That God of Abraham.
Say Abraham, yami.
All this is taking care of your children.
Wo a washe wo ma imfri imfinshie nyine mu no.
And now she's applying the token.
Afei odi nshensodie no edi juma.
We know token is the message of your age.
Nshensodie ne ene nkranse ma wo yemfinshie mu.
Token is the Holy Ghost.
Eno ne honkonkon.
Token is our righteousness.
Eno ne yetine ne yo.
To have the token means you are living fully obedient to the word of God. So you see how she's applying the token in prayer. That's what we should do in some few minutes to come. He said, I have tried to live true and upright to thee.
Said,
and now I am here seeing my little boy crying for something to eat. So pitiful, eh?
But Abraham said that she couldn't sleep through the night.
Because
the son was always crying.
They
were eating only once in 3 days. No, they were eating once in 3 days. I can't read that because of time. So the son was so hungry, crying. They couldn't sleep through the night. So she went on her knees and was praying like this.
Abraham
says sometimes she opened the windows and she just is waiting for the sun day to break. For day to break. For them to eat their last meal. And die. She said, I've tried to live right for thee. And there's a place she said that, and I, your handmaid has lived true. My husband was lost in the battle. The battle for the Lord. So the husband too was also serving God. And I have been a widow for several years now. I have tried to live right and keep your commandments. You see how she's applying the token?
Abraham says that
when you are going into prayers, apply the token like Uzziah did. If I'm right,
Uzziah,
when the prophet told him he's going to die,
said,
God, I've tried to live right for you all these years. How many times do we pray? It's true. How many times do we pray? And we apply the token. And we say, God, you know, I've tried to live right for you. Since I heard the message of the hour, I've tried to live right for you. I don't fornicate. I am a true husband to my wife. I don't commit adultery. I don't smoke. I don't lie. I don't cheat my co-workers. I pay my tithe and offering. I am living right for you. How many times do we apply the token when we are praying that we can chest out and say, God, I'm living right. I'm living true. I don't sin. I'm living a holy life. How many times do we say these things before we go to pray and ask God for our needs?
How many times
do we pray? We ought to put God first by obeying His commandments. The entire message of the hour, living right, living righteously, then applying that token in our prayers. Because when we do that,
yes, sir,
God is obligated to answer our prayers. When we put Him first and when we apply the token,
which
is obeying the fullness of His word and going into a serious prayer like the woman did by going on the knees on the floor, praying by crying, Abba Father, seeking first the kingdom of God in His righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto us.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters,
time
couldn't permit us to say, but let me read this last quote.
Okay,
then we'll go in prayers. I said it earlier on.
Okay, no.
But let me read it.
But
before I read,
and son of a king, kind of,
but Abraham said,
what if Abraham say,
when the woman did all this,
gave
all that she had, all that she had, last thing that she had, then the word of God came.
To her.
He said, "Thus said the Lord God of heaven and earth."
Ask
the Lord God liveth.
Your
oil shall never run out. Your muscle of milk shall never run out.
Even
your water shall never run out. Until I, God, shall call back rain on earth. When a whole nation was going through that chaos because of the life of a king, God had a witness at that time, and God took care of his witness. He
should
stand to be God's witness in this condition that we find ourselves in now. The way things are going, you should put God first and apply the talking. And when we're going to prayers, there is no way God will not come to our
knees. Amen.
In the message, how can I overcome?
Abraham
said in paragraph 119, just remember,
Kai,
we are living for God. You have one objective. And that is Jesus Christ.
And only Jesus Christ. Amen.
I wish I could break this down. Outside of that, there is nothing else that counts.
Our
life that we are living is for Jesus Christ. And if you are living for Christ, you do not live for yourself. You live for your neighbor. Oh, how I wish I could break this down. And living for your neighbor applies in every aspect of our life. From head to toe, our dressing, our way of speaking, our conduct. How am I living for my fellow human being to have salvation if I should dress and I don't dress when I dress naked and
myself? Oh,
I said I wish I could break this down. Then secondly, for your family. Then thirdly, for yourself. But first, for God. Next, for your family. And next, for you. You are number three. That is the end of the road. You put yourself last.
Amen.
Oh my, it's a powerful statement. I can imagine a man like me. I can imagine a man like me. I dress well. Somebody look at my wife. Or look at my children. Or look at my mother. Or my cousin. They are not dressing well. Probably I get money, I keep it to myself. I just put something small on the table for chop money. I don't care about their school fees. I just don't care about their health. Thinking about myself and how my friends will see me. Because I'm a CEO or I'm working in some organization. Such a pity. The Bible says a man who cannot take care of his household is like an infidel. So for we men, and for you as a woman or a sister, put it to your own
so
self.
Onyabema,
but Abraham says,
Abraham say,
that this life they were living
for,
all that we're living for in our life, is for Christ.
Christo inti.
He said, God first.
Nyankupon no dikain.
Your family second.
Webusya di atosu mienu.
Your family is not only your wife, your children, your husband, your nephews, your nieces, your cousins, your grandparents. Some of them have told for you to be where you are today. You see them and you try to shy away from them. And lastly, it's you. You are last. So if therefore the little you have, when you realize that when I share it, and when it comes to the last person,
Mine will be little.
Me die be soa.
Or I may not even get some.
Ebi krampa mi nyebi.
Then you must do more.
And there was all your dodo.
So that when you share it,
sarabia wo cha,
you can have enough for yourself.
Benya kakra ama wo.
We didn't have enough time.
Ye nyamre.
But I believe we've gotten the message.
Brothers
and sisters, for the rest of our lives, before the rapture comes, let us put God first. Let us apply the token. And in prayer, shall I please be outstanding? Living by faith in Jesus abide, trusting, confining in His great love. From all I'm saved, I'm living my faith and feel no alarm. Wherever you are, just begin to pray for yourself. I don't have to call what you should pray. You know yourself. You know your Christian life. You know how you are not putting God first. How you are putting God even last. How even you are not even considering God at all. And you know about how you are treating your family. How you are treating God in paying your tithe and offering. You know yourself. Just begin to pray.
Shelter we know, I'm living by faith and feel no alarm. I cannot see they what the morrow may bring. If shadow or sunshine or rain, the Lord I know ruleth over everything, and all of my worries vain. Living by faith in Jesus abide, trusting, confiding in His great love. From all I'm saved in the shelter arena, I'm living by faith and feel no alarm. Don't tempest may blow and the storm clouds arise, obscuring the brightness of light. I'm never alone at the overcast sky. The mass the looks on at the strife. Living by faith in Jesus I
standing in His great love. From all I'm saved in His shelter, I'm living by faith and feel no other.
Brothers and sisters, let us continue to pray. As a sermon came forth, are we able to, in our prayer, say, are we able to say that, oh God, I have lived right. God, I have not fornicated. God, I have not lied. God, you know how I have tried to live through ever since I got this message. If you know that we are not able to say this thing by applying the talking in prayers, let's begin to pray that God will help us. The next time when we are going to prayers, we can say, oh God, how I've lived right for you. So that when you are praying about how your business is going down, so that when you are praying about how you want God to promote you, so that when you want to pray on how God should heal your sickness, pray for somebody that you can pray in that manner. Tell God to help you to seek Him first and His righteousness. Knowing that when you do that, every other thing shall be added unto you. We need to pray.
Pass me now, O gentle Savior. My hand, O Christ, why on earth thou do not pass me. Crying sails of Savior, 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 my humble cry, while on others thou art scorned.
Brothers and sisters, I want us to know that the world that we are living into now, with all the corruption and the immorality going on, time couldn't permit the preaching to say more about that. Last Sunday, I went to wash my car, the washing bay at Sprinters. A man got into conversation with me. An elderly man about 60 years old. He was talking about how expensive cars are now. Three times the price now. He said it's because the people are not looking for God. They are looking for their own selfish deed first. That is why prices are escalating. He said, man is not thinking about his fellow man. He's thinking about his own self. Look at our politics. In the religious realm. That is why the world is going the way it is going. And the man said, the only way that we can survive in our time now is to
have God. Brothers, it is not your job. It is not your money in your bank account. Early this year, two banks in America collapsed.
America.
Not even Ghana. Where do Ghana stand?
Ghana,
America.
America.
It is not our effort. Better than sisters. To survive in our time now, we need God. It is not about your paycheck. No. We need God to survive in this our time. So let's go into prayers to know that for us to survive in this our time, we need to be able to read our Bible and our message
book
without God being first.
So
we cannot make it. Shall we pray?
Tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, I cannot bear this alone. In my distress, He kindly will help me. He ever loves and cares for His soul. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, I cannot bear my burdens alone. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus.
Shall we finally pray? Let's remember this local assembly. Let's remember our pastor, his family, church officers and their family, every brother, every sister and their family, that we put God first,
who
come to church early,
who
clap and sing, pay our tithe and offering,
who
will be concerned about lost souls, not about building the church to beautify it. No. That should be our prayer. Let's also remember our pastor once more. A revelation came about him being attacked. Not him alone, by the church also. And the church too, not him alone. So just let's combine this prayers and go before the Lord. Shall we pray?
Tempted and tried, I need a Savior, one who can help my burdens to bear. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus,
that is alone. I must tell Jesus. I must tell Jesus. Jesus can help.
Our Heavenly Father, we thank you tonight. Father, we have come here with one heart, O Lord. We want to better our lives. Father, Lord, you have spoken to us that we must apply the token in our lives, O Lord. And Father, Lord, we appreciate all that has happened, O God. We know this message is really precious to us. And Father, we are praying that God, you give us the strength and ability to move forward. We pray that God, you help us that we can stand firm for the word. We know that God, this message comes from your throne for we to live as Christians in this last age, O God. Father, we thank you for using your man, servant, to preach the word. We pray that God, whatever he has lost, you will replenish it, O God. You will strengthen him that anytime he mounts the pulpit, O God, he will get the strength to preach your word to us, O God. We pray for the pastor of this fellowship, O God. Father, we pray that you strengthen him, you anoint him, you give him more anointing, O God, to press on and feed us with the word of God. We pray, O Lord, for each one of us. Even as we go to our various homes, your spirit will continue to abide with us. We know that we cannot do it by ourselves. We know that, Father, Lord, it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's the spirit of God. We pray for Brother William. He's actually traveling. We pray that God himself will give him traveling mercies. We know that God, you have already done it. We soak his journey into your hands, Father. May he come with a testimony. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Shall we clap for Jesus? We sing Living by Faith. We like to take the offering, Living by Faith. I cannot today what tomorrow may be, shadow or sunshine or rain. The Lord I know ruler over everything, and all of my worry in vain. Living by faith, living by faith. Shall we sing to the glory of Jesus? Says Abba. Oh, trusting, confiding, oh, in his great love. From all I'm saying, he's sheltering us. I'm living by faith. Though tempests may blow and the storm clouds arise, obscuring the brightness of light, I'm never alarmed at the overcast sky. The master looks on our strife. Living by faith, living by faith. Jesus Abba,
trusting, confiding in his great love. From all I'm saved, in his sheltering arms, I'm living by faith.
Hallelujah.
Forgive me for taking your time. Amen.
Amen.
So your desperation will always draw the prophet to you.
Amen.
That's what Jesus said.
And now Jesus say,
there were so many windows in Samaria.
Nana eponu bebre ewo Samaria.
But because of her desperation,
enam na wunye hiemu.
A prophet was commanded.
Yeah, odi ye she odi fobi.
To go to her.
So onkon in chain.
So your desperation.
Into wa wunye hiemu no.
Draw the prophet.
Ebe mo fobi abenu. Amen. Amen.
And Sunday we'll give the full details about the memorial service for our brother Martin.
Nyamia Duma, Diefa, Osuma Efo Nya Martin Hono, Yedinjeni Nabema, Sorin, Nyamia Duma Kusiada.
But in short, the memorial service will be held at the end time Tabernacle.
In Kaya Sumono, Yabaye Ewoila, Asafumu.
On the 10th of September.
September, there it also, Edu.
And so that day, there will be no Sunday school.
Sadano ye nye Sunday school.
So the church will start from 9:30.
Asone besha siye 9:30.
By 11 they close.
11 ni upon.
And then we have a bus to take the people who
nafe
who don't have their cars to go.
Yenya bus ebefa one hour ni wotia se namno no wako la.
But some of us will be the first batch to go and start from the beginning.
See, you move in on midi kind ako share or some no ase.
So we'll go in two batches.
See, you be call in some zoom you know.
First batch with a family.
Did you kind any ebusiano?
And then second batch will continue when
you toss me you know ever to us.
So Sunday will give you the fruit.
Yami aduma kusiada. God
bless
you.
So let's all be praying towards
him.
And let's continue to remember the family.
They
are going through much stress. But the Lord is their comforter. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So kindly give us a closing hymn.
Oft times as days seem long, our trials hard to bear. We tempted to complain to mama and despair. But Christ will soon appear to catch his bride away. Or tears forever over in God's eternal day. It will be worth it all when we see Jesus. Life's trials will seem so small. When we see Christ, one glimpse of his dear face, all sorrow will erase. So bravely run the race, till we see Christ. Sometimes the sky looks dark, with not a ray of light. With toss and grief.
I will meet you in the morning.
Just inside.
Just inside the eastern gate.
Then be ready, faithful pilgrim.